Hey everyone, Howard Pinsky here with another Photoshop tutorial from Your Questions. Today we're going to be taking a look at a feature that can take your selections to the next level, and that is Refine Edge. If you've ever done work with subjects that contain hair or fur, you know what kind of a chore it can be to extract them from their background. Refine Edge allows you to single out individual strands of hair or fur, resulting in a much better extraction. Let me show you how this works. So here I am in Adobe Photoshop, where we're going to take a look at two examples on how Refine Edge can help you tremendously in your projects. In this first photo here, which I grabbed from Shutterstock.com, you can clearly see that this lady has a lot of hair going on in this photo. There's hair everywhere. And using the traditional selection methods in Photoshop, you're going to get a pretty ugly extraction. So the first thing that we need to do is make our initial selection. Now in this case, because the background is pretty much a solid color, I'm actually going to start by selecting the background itself. And of course, just like most things in Photoshop, there are many ways of doing this. But for this example, I'm going to be using Color Range, which can be found under the Select menu. Now the way Color Range works, and I've covered this in the past, it allows you to select individual colors in your photo and turn them into a selection. You're going to notice as I select the blue at the top right corner, a little bit has become a selection in our preview. Now if I hold down my shift key, I can add to that selection just like this. I can actually drag my mouse over top of all the blues and those will be added to my selection. And then if I move my window over to the right a little bit, I can grab the blues in this area that were not selected. Basically what I'm looking for is white and black. White will become my selection and black will be left alone. So I'm going to finish off by grabbing a little bit of the blue at the bottom right hand corner, and I'm now left with a pretty nice black and white result. But of course for this example, as we want the model selected and not the background, I'm going to check invert right over here at the bottom right, and then press OK, which is going to give me my selection of just the model. Now like I mentioned previously, using a traditional selection method like this will give you pretty ugly extractions. If I simply go and apply a layer mask, you're going to notice that the edges of the model's hair look terrible. So let me undo Command or Control Z, and this time instead of applying a layer mask or simply deleting the background, we want to use the Refine Edge feature, which can be found under the Select menu as well. Now before we get into the good stuff, there are a few ways you can view how your preview looks. You can choose from Marching Ants, Overlay, On Black, On White, Black and White, On Layers, or Reveal Layer. And you can also cycle through your views by pressing the F key or disable them temporarily by pressing X. Now if we go to On Black, you can really see how traditional selection methods are terrible at selecting hair or fur. But luckily Refine Edge is here to save the day. Now right down below under your view options you have edge detection, and this is where the magic happens. You're going to want to start by turning on smart radius, which at first isn't going to do anything. But as you start increasing the radius, Photoshop is going to start refining the area around your subject that contains hair or fur. And depending on the size of the photo or how much hair or fur the model contains, you may want to increase the radius even more to get more refinement. Now at this point, if I press the P key on my keyboard to see the original, the refinement has certainly helped, but there's still a lot of blue in the background that we need to deal with. Once you get to this point, there are a few things you can do to resolve this issue. The first thing is the Refine Radius tool, which can be found to the left-hand side of your Refine Edge window. And this helps by expanding the detection area outside of your subject. And it works just like a brush. So you can use your right and left square bracket keys on your keyboard to make the brush bigger or smaller. And then in most cases, all you have to do is simply brush right around the outline of your model, just like I'm doing right here. So I'm going to go right along the outline of the model, all the way around. And this will tell Photoshop to really expand the area outside of the subject, just like this. And when I let go, you're going to notice we now have a much more refined selection. And that definitely helped a lot, but we still have a little bit of blue around the subject. So the next feature you can use is decontaminate colors at the bottom of the Refine Edge window. And what this will do, this will tell Photoshop to look for those colors that might be spilling in from the background onto the subject. And in this case, the main color was blue. So when you turn decontaminate colors on, it's going to work to get rid of those colors that were spilling over. And you can increase the amount if there's still a little bit of color left over. Now, once again, taking a look at the original by pressing P on the keyboard and taking a look at what we have now, there's a huge improvement. And even though we have a little bit of ghosting left over, there's a good chance that once you add an image behind your subject, you won't see that at all. But if you do want to refine it even more, we have the option to adjust the edge. You can choose to smooth out any jagged edges that might be visible. You can choose to feather the selection, which will soften it out a little bit. You can increase the contrast, which will usually sharpen up the edges a little bit. And you can shift the edge in or out, which sometimes helps a lot. So in this case, if you take a look right beside the book on the right side, there's a little bit of blue left over. And of course, we have a little bit of blue left over to the right of the hair. This is a case where I'd want to shift the edge to the left, which will pull it inwards a little bit. And you'll notice when I start to shift the edge, we now have an even better result. The blue on the right side of the book is gone, and a lot of the ghosting that was apparent on the right side of the hair is now gone as well. And like I mentioned, the area to the right of the hair, that little bit of ghosting, there's a good chance that won't be seen when you add another image in the background. So now that our refinement is just about complete, we need to choose how we want to output it. If you did not choose decontaminate colors, you can choose to output it as a selection or just a layer mask. But because that was checked on, we can choose to output it as a new layer with a layer mask, a new document, or a new document with a layer mask. For me, I always choose to output it as a new layer with a layer mask. That will allow you to make further refinements later on if you need to. And when you press OK, you're going to be left with an extraction that contains a layer mask as well, as you can see in the layers panel. Now, just to show you how well this extracted, I'm going to grab this other photo right here. I'm going to drag it onto this document, and I'm going to simply enlarge it just like this and place it right behind the model. And you can now really see that the individual strands of hair look fantastic in our extraction. Ending up with a result like this using a traditional selection method without refined edge is nearly impossible. Now, the nice thing about refined edge is that you can use it on pretty much any selection. It doesn't only have to be on a solid colored background. So in this photo here, which doesn't have a solid color background, I can do the same thing and use refined edge to grab a nice selection of this dog and its fur. So for this example, I'm going to grab my quick selection tool, which can be found on the tools bar in the left, which I actually just did a video on last Thursday. So check out my YouTube channel, youtube.com/iceflowstudios, if you want to know the difference between the magic wand tool and the quick selection tool. And once that's been selected, I'm going to simply brush over top of this dog to turn it into a selection. Now you're going to notice that some areas outside of the dog have also been selected as well. And in that case, I can simply hold down my Alt or Option key, Option on the Mac, Alt on Windows, to subtract from the selection. And over here, I can just grab this area over here. And I'm not looking for a perfect selection, but I do want to select as much of the hair as possible. So I'm going to decrease the brush size a little bit, brush over top of this hair here, the hair over here, and you'll notice that Photoshop just selected all of this area as well. Hold down Alt or Option and subtract, just like that. And finally, I'm going to subtract from this section right over here and add this little strand of hair on the right. So now that we have our very basic selection, like I mentioned before, if you were to simply add a layer mask, you get a very ugly cutout type of extraction. So let me undo that, Command and Control Z. And once again, we're going to hop into Refine Edge. Now, because I have a selection method active, I can simply hit Refine Edge on the options bar, or again, I can find it under the Select menu. And just like we did before, I'm going to turn on Smart Radius and then increase the radius value until my selection starts looking really nice. Right about there, we can start to see the individual strands of hair. And if I switch over to the black and white view, you can really see how much Photoshop has refined this selection. I'm going to hop back over to the on black view, and then with my refine radius tool, I'm going to start to brush around the outline of this dog to expand the selection, which will give me a much nicer result. So I'm going to brush up the left side of the dog, just like this, around the fur. And once I let go of my mouse, you're going to notice we have a near perfect selection of this dog, which contains fur, which, like I mentioned, with a traditional selection method would be nearly impossible. In this case, I'm not going to need to turn on decontaminate colors, so I'm going to output it as a new layer with a layer mask, press OK, and there is my final result. So if I go back here, if I grab this photo once again, drag this over here to this document, I'm going to enlarge it, place it behind the dog, and there is the final result. And once again, you have a layer mask available to you in case you need any further refinements. As a quick example, you may notice at the bottom right-hand corner where the collar is, there's a little bit of transparency. So I can press B on my keyboard to grab a brush, make sure that the color is set to white, and then simply brush over top of this area to bring back the original pixels, just like that. And we're now left with two fantastic extractions of a dog that contained fur and a woman that contained crazy hair. And that is Refine Edge in Photoshop, a tool that is not only going to save you a ton of time and hassle, but more importantly, you're going to be left with fantastic looking extractions. Thanks for watching, guys, and as always, make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel to be kept up to date on new videos, follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, and stay tuned for a new tip on Thursday and another Photoshop tutorial next Monday. Take care.